Welcome to Lovers of Jesus Ministries International. The message you are about to hear is from the Lord's anointed, Dr. Edward Irobi, the man with the mandate to proclaim the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ and to raise an army for the Lord in this end time.
So that's leading us to this week's discussion, the beginning of sorrows. Please follow me. Let's go to the word of the Lord in the book of Matthew. Matthew chapter 24. Remember, in the book of Matthew chapter 24, the Lord predicted a lot of things for the end of time. Matthew 24, I will read verse number 1 to 8 very fast. Then Jesus went out and departed from the temple, and his disciples came up to show him the buildings of the temple. And Jesus said to them, "Do you not see all these things? Assuredly, I say to you, not one stone shall be left here upon another that shall not be thrown down." Now, verse number 3. Now, as he sat on the Mount of Olives, the disciples came to him privately, saying, "Tell us, when will these things be? And what will be the sign of your coming? And of the end of the age?" Let's see what the Lord Jesus responded. Verse number 4. And Jesus answered and said to them, "Take heed that no one deceives you. For many will come in my name, saying, 'I am the Christ,' and will deceive many. And you will hear of wars and rumors of wars. See that you are not troubled, for all these things must come to pass, but the end is not yet. For nation will rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom. And there will be famine, pestilences, and earthquakes in various places. All these are the beginning of sorrows." You see why we are studying the beginning of sorrows today? The Lord wants us to be aware, well informed, during this end of time. All these things are the beginning of sorrows. For nation will rise against nation, kingdom against kingdom. We are seeing all this in our generation. I just want to let you know what I call stormy clusters. Stormy clusters. I want you to hear this. Stormy clusters blow globally now, as we are seeing all over the world. There are a lot of things coming together. They are ranging from coronavirus to potential economic collapses and mounting natural disasters. Somebody may ask, is it possible that this sudden clustering of woes is a sign that our personal and national sins have reached a tipping point, and that God is allowing his judgment to descend upon us? So, remember, we are exploring the beginning of sorrows, as the Lord Jesus highlighted. So the critical question for all countries at this critical point is, when in God's eyes does sin become national and not merely personal, and thus the entire society is brought to the tipping point of judgment? Here is the answer. When the government of a nation misuses its God-given authority to give official sanction to sin, the nation itself, and not just individuals within it, comes under judgment. That's why we are saying, America, watch out. Developed nations, watch out. You have legalized same-sex marriage. Watch out. You are trying to stand against the law of God. Watch out. You are trying to bring law against anybody that will oppose your non-biblically sanctioned agenda. Watch out. Be careful so that your country will not be experiencing tipping point, which is part of this beginning of sorrows. The Lord Jesus predicted in Matthew chapter 24, where we read from verse 5, the Lord highlighted some things we have to watch out as we are exploring the beginning of sorrows. Number one, he says what? False Christ will arise. I want to ask you a question. Have you heard of any false Christ before? Have you heard of false Jesus Christ here and there? Have you heard? I want to give you time to think about that. Remember what the Lord said in verse number 5. For many will come in my name saying, I am the Christ, and will deceive many. It may interest you to know that a false Christ or a false prophet is a pretender who claims to be the one sent from God to save humanity. Have you not heard of different false Christs that has been in existence since? They are pretending. They say, they have the answer to human problem. And after some time, they will fizzle out. They will just fall away. The Lord Jesus has really provided warning for us. False Christs have come and gone since the first century. If you check out the word of the Lord, they arise when someone claims to be the Messiah, or when a branch of Christianity wears from the clear teaching of Christ's word and tries to define Jesus as one that he is, and tries to define Jesus as other than he is. So some people try to define Jesus, he's one of the prophets. Oh, he's not divine, and they try to water the word of God. Remember what Brother John said, that the Antichrist spirit is already in the world. We don't have to overlook that. The spirit of the Antichrist is already in the world. John gave a clear definition of accurate Christology. By this, you know the spirit of God. Every spirit that confesses that Jesus Christ has come in the flesh is of God. And every spirit that does not confess that Jesus Christ has come in the flesh is not of God. So this is one of the ways we can use to separate or segregate all these false Christs. Very soon, because we are at the end of time, you'll be hearing a lot of false Christs. You know about what's happening in Jerusalem right now. You know about the Messiah. A lot of Jewish rabbis are clustering around the young man, saying that, the young man has memorized Torah since he was young. And he has been performing healings and miracles and so on. Is this not the Messiah we are waiting for? That's not my Messiah. That's not our Jesus. I want you to be careful so that you will not be deceived. That's why the Lord wants us to examine this important information today. The beginning of sorrows as predicted by the only Christ, the eternal Son of God, who liveth from eternity to eternity. False Christs have continued to make their appearance even within the last century. Certain men such as Jim Jones, Sun Myung Moon, and David Koresh have risen to prominence by claiming to be God or his right-hand man. They often started with the Bible, but then seized one verse or idea and built their own theology around this, turning their group into a self-affirming cult. We have to be very careful so that anything we hear, if it's not in line with the word of God, it will not affect us. We have to know the spirit of the Antichrist. And we don't have to delve into that because they are not the spirit of the Lord. All these things are part of the beginning of sorrows that the Lord Jesus highlighted here.
I'd rather have Jesus than anything this world.